Madagascan President André Rajoelina has officially launched a medicine he believes can prevent and cure patients suffering from COVID-19. Developed by the Malagasy Institute of Applied Research and branded COVID Organics, President Rajoelina presented the so-called remedy to the press on Monday. It contains artemisia, a plant cultivated on the Big Island to fight against malaria.
All trials and tests have been conducted, and its effectiveness in reducing the elimination of symptoms has been proven for the treatment of patients with COVID-19 in Madagascar.
President Rajoelina said Monday that it had cured two COVID-19 cases. A presidential decree said COVID organics is mandatory for school children returning to school on Wednesday.
So today I think that I am convinced, in fact, that history will prove us right. But today there are already two cases that have been cured with the COVID organics, but we'll actually see what happens next. COVID organics will be used in prophylaxis, that is, preventive measure. But clinical observations have shown a trend towards its effectiveness in curative measures as well. Other clinical studies are currently underway.
Rajoelina's claims come amid scientific opinion that no cure for COVID-19 exists and that any experimental formula should be rigorously tested to see if it is safe and effective.
We know business where one wants to say, but we know how the Africans, when they never have no gun and be in it, them use them African retentive things to conquer the Europeans. And St. Thomas is one of them places that even though you hear, say, Paul Bogle was a deacon, and we know, say, the Africans, them usually use the church as a gathering point for the beginning of some uprisings, or most of the uprisings, because that was the only place the African them could have gathered without Europeans disperse them. And when we are say Paul Bogle no, as a deacon, we know say Paul Bogle never left him African traditions. You know, and we know that most of the ones them who conduct slave rebellions and slave uprisings, they maintain them African medicine. We them call them bush doctor. We hear mythologies and stories about Nanny. Oh, Nanny used to take her bottom and catch bullet and all them something there. We hear of stories that Nanny did a boil water without fire and eat it and throw down on the hillside when the English them come up there. Well, true or not, it give rise to the understanding that most of the leaders of the African rebellion them was where people revere, the African them revere as healers or Obia man. And that is why the white people them make it illegal, because them realize there's something that rally. There was a rallying point around certain people because they were seen as herbalists. I want to say herbalists, we're not talking about ganja man now. We are talking about herbalists, where them know certain herbs to deal with certain sickness, and them know certain things where them can use and kill you, even though it's not bombs and not guns. And who can forget Taki, who led the greatest slave rebellion in the Caribbean, not in Jamaica. And Taki was one of them serious herbalists. That's why the African them rally around him. And then we cannot forget Bookman. Bookman, who went to Haiti and become one of the main instigators of that Haitian revolution. And we know, and them will tell you when you go to Haiti, that Bookman was a voodoo priest. So when we talk about St. Thomas, We don't want the ones them who are going like feel no way, say we are carried on them parish. We don't carry on them parish. And almost certain people believe that the majority of people them where we come in contact with know what we are talking about when we say St. Thomas. Then why you think say them make St. Thomas suffer so? Because St. Thomas give them Paul Bogle, and Paul Bogle was the one who decides say him not take nothing from these guys no more, that the man walk from Stoli Gut to Spanish Town, St. Jago de la Vega, just to talk to the governor, and him never want to talk to him. So you know, so the man is serious. And when him go to the church, sorry, down at the courthouse, is a woman throw the first stone in at the courthouse. You think it's Paul Bogle do that? It's Paul Bogle. Go long left to tell him, said, no, you know. Them can't do what them are doing. Meaning they're the white people, them illegally are doing certain things. And a woman just got the crowd and shy a stone in there. And for you know, so crowd stay. Crowd need that one person to start something and everybody start something. And them just start to shy stone and this there goes now. What them call the Moran Day Rebellion. So we understand and we know St. Thomas. So we want to heal up Tabby and all them man who know St. Thomas. Rebellion and rebellious. St. Mary, rebellion and rebellious. And we know, say, them think they will come round again if you know my job. Because I hear them talk about COVID and all them something there. Maybe the cure for COVID, they in some obscure place in Jamaica where people now have a check out. Maybe the cure feed, there's some obscure place where nobody now check out. So we have to figure it out. We have to figure it out. So, yes, we still again want to heal up the people, them in St. Thomas, especially St. Thomas. When we remember Three Finger Jack, them are the teacher about Three Finger Jack in a Jamaica history book, them. Three Finger Jack was what them say, as a criminal, it was like a Robin Hood. According to white people that talk about Robin Hood. Three Finger Jack, I'm three finger by one I'm on them. And trust me, them man them make white people miserable in Jamaica. Miserable, them life was miserable in Jamaica. So we have some man who stand up there. We want to heal up Shane Clark at the studio again, you know. Heal up Shane Clark. Do a thing.
Yeah, man, big up.
Do a thing, Shane Clark. Believe you me. That capturing Rasta is one thing, you know. When we really understand where we're going about the capturing a Rasta from them time there until now. Irians. We want to mention Irians. We want to yell up Irians because when we just start being gay and see Irians, the man that try was like fire in a living fire. When you talk about baptism by fire, them man they are the fire. And we go a bingy all over and I don't remember one bingy I ever go where Irians no there. A chant round the fire. Sometimes the fire blaze. You think it's like a burn-down place, but the thing with Bingy, man, them know how to curtail fire and make the fire stay at one place and burn. So Irians, we want to help Irians because on his 50th anniversary with him and his wife, him invite her to, yeah, to play music. And we feel good to know that after 50 years, I say, Mota, are you me want to come to my house come play some music? I say, yes, what you mean? Because a long time we are going yard a bingy and go all over the place. But here one know, after a man a Rasta, for I have say 3/5 time life, you know, or 3/4 time life. Me I say 99% time life in my Rasta. and him a grow him locks and him have him beard. And him pick them, grow them locks. And him pick me, him grand pick them, grow them locks and them thing there. For you really know, come in at this time here, when we think that we did pass certain things, if you come here and say, Ira Irons in a hospital, because of some fall when him get on, him go hospital. And if you say, them trim off the Rasta man beard. A serious thing that, because, hey, I'm going to tell a story again now. I know I tell it years, I mean, 20 years ago, we had this program. I'm going to tell it like 10 times. You know, when we used to live a mountain, I'd be a bridge, and invite me a guy, a Bahamas. I'm going to say, oh, you mean, of course. I'm going to go to Bahamas. And we sit down with about 13 Rasta man in our yard. Just a reason. You know, the Bahamas, you know, me talk about Nassau, Bahamas. And policeman come in at the yard and scrape up the wall away and carry go to jail and lock up in a jail and say, Rasta, on a sal tonight, you know. And then put me in a one different cell, and you don't put me in a one different cell now. Them say, where you come from? Me say, Jamaica, me come from. You know, say, them say, then where you do a Bahamas? Me say, what you mean, me do a Bahamas? The brethren invite me down here, and me come for come look on Bahamas. Me in a nice hotel and thing where obviously Rasta never go in at a hotel before because in a them days, all them look on Rasta, you know, some dirty head, nasty people. The police them send police down at the hotel to find out if I choose to stay at the hotel. When them go down there, the people them say, yeah, there's someone here by the name of that book in the hotel. One policeman in at the station now say, me want to trim the wall out, you know. Me say, what? How will I talk about trim? No, people. Is the first in my life I ever know, say. You see, people are saying, you can't grow, you can't grow back. I don't know if them cut off your last. You can't grow back. Well, you ever know. You see, when him tell me that, me never believe that. Me say, him have to go kill me. Him not cut off my locks. You see, about 7 men in a one cell, you know. And the 7 youth, them know, is a weird thing about them 7 youth, you know, because them reach in Bahamas for go to America. And all them are going to reach America now is that them live at the park and a person tell them say them can't get him, him can't get them in America with some church convention and all them stuff. There. And them give my money, the person, and the person, them reach Bahamas and the police man will have find them. But they never do that. So you know, you see the man them who have the locks, the policeman take out one, and me you, Lord God, Lord, don't you miss her. You see, me see the brother come out, the brother head baller than my bottom to rotted. You see, look what me and another one a ball out, you know. You see me look, the brethren come round, him head ball. So me say, no, this serious now because me nah go, them go kill me. Them have to go kill me inside and so now. Anyway, them take me out of my cell now and carry me going at the front now. I see the man, the man, like a car probably, me has car key close to them little key in him hand where them used to put out of them arm and them thing there. And them take the key and lift up my locks. And I said, then tell me something. Them allow you pan aeroplane like this? Me say, yes, sir. I'm say, let me see your passport. At least I go see of me, you know. It's when he opened my passport, him see German visa in there, him see American visa in there, him see British visa in there, him realize now, say, rotted. I know ordinary citizen this. And him not come from Bahamas. a Jamaica I'm come from, and him is somebody. Cause him a look low. In a them days, a Rasta now fly up and down in the Caribbean. Him a thinks he has somebody now. This brother here is somebody. So him say, "What you want?" Me say, "What me want? You are going to know. Send me back on the next plane, go to Jamaica. Because me can walk out the world of Nassau in a, like 20 odd miles, me walk out the world of Nassau. And me come here, so no come and get treated. Send me go back to Jamaica." Anyway, them send me go back to Jamaica and left me lax. Why me I tell this story is that it's the first time in my life me ever reach a situation where me feel like, say, even though people are talking about your lax can grow back, me feel like, say, they would have to kill me in there if they want me down for cut my locks. Now, I tell you about Irians. Irians are weird film locks from me a baby. And them be dead with him. And somebody in a Linstead Hospital. Call out the name of the hospital. Somebody in a Linstead Hospital. Because the Rasta man is not in the condition. If you know where you're going, if you understand where you're going, if you fight back and retaliate, them cut off him beard. So me tell him daughter, say, "Look here, go get a lawyer, you know. I'm glad for hear them get a lawyer upon the case. I'm glad for hear they get a lawyer upon the case because we done fight. For them things there, to stop. And for seeing at this time, yeah. I wanted to look on a Rasta man, an elder Rasta man, the one who do it could have been him grand pick me. The one who do it, the way things are going now. And for see, say, them cut off the ample beard Rasta. May I tell you, it's terrible. I have some little people on the corner say that all Rasta should have them own hospital. Here one now. Nobody no bring them food, she said to me, you know, because here one now. Rasta come from Jamaica and they are privy to the same conditions that ordinary Jamaicans find themselves in. Now, you may have to say conditions now. Them can be rich, them can be poor, them can live in a ghetto, them can live uptown. If a Jamaican in a Jamaica sick, him supposed to want to go to hospital because I'm in hospital already. And nobody can come tell me no say me a Rasta when me a doing a Babylon hospital. Because a doctor, whether my Babylon doctor or not, is not supposed to see creed, religion, or political ideas that it can define who must look after, who must look after. Him take a oath. So, you see if a Rasta man sick, or a Muslim sick, or a anybody in a Jamaica was sick, and him don't have the facility to take care of him in the sickness, and him go to doctor. You see the people who are ball out about, yeah man, and him go to doctor, watch a man. And them people they are fight against Rasta. And sometimes I know certain class of people do it, you know. And the same ghetto class of people we stand up and I say, "Yeah, Rasta, you know, talk about Babylon, you know, Ghana doctor." Yes, if me have certain sickness, I mean, on this one, me I go to a doctor. I just say, "Go." You understand? Just like if me want food, me go a market, I me go a supermarket. Nobody can come to me with Rasta. You know, you go to a supermarket, like bone supermarket. Yeah, bone supermarket when me know in there. Light it a fire when me know in there. But that's why the people them know say it's an infringement on the rights of anyone in Jamaica for you to now turn around because them come to be taken care of medically. To now look upon him here. Because what you know, you see when you cut off Iryan's beard, it come like you cut off one of them hand, you know. It come like you cut off one of them finger. It come like you cut off one of them toe. And so we look upon it, you know. We don't look upon it ordinary, you know, like, yeah, if me want to cut my lock, make me cut it. But nobody's supposed to put them on for me and say, because me didn't know I help is not cut off my lock. If disease want to take my locks off for me, make disease take it. But no one is supposed to do that. That is an infringement. And it's only a hypocrite. And really somebody who seriously have fight against Rasta. If you come talk about say, they're the Rasta doing a Babylon hospital. I mean, we're Rasta doing a Babylon hospital. We there, so. You think, say, the COVID disease of any special person right now, like, okay, you see you over there, you praise Jesus every day, and now I go to you. You over there, all right. No, I don't say it work. I don't say it work. It not discriminate. It lick who it want to lick. Like sickness, if certain things, because you don't, sometimes you don't seek inwardly, which is the brethren. The brethren never seek inwardly, you know. It's fall down. You understand? And find himself in a certain position, situation. So, me don't know. Them just take with it us. And it now go so, you know. It now go so. Because every time we come and say anything and them come up with something different, it's like, yeah, things say, the thing gone and it just different. Yes, this is the Cutting Edge on RFM. Go out like them a red Rasta, but you want to know. You see, Coral Garden, you see, after Coral Garden, we wasn't supposed to be there, you know, because I listened to come to Jamaica 1966, 3 years after Coral Garden. Well, you see, Coral Garden now, well, you go far back than Coral Garden in the 50s, when Leonard Owill did in the pinnacle, and Bustamante, one of the national heroes of Jamaica, go up there, go burn down the place and run roof around there, lick up and lick up, roof lick up, and them disperse. Rasta was supposed to be forgotten them time there, you know. But guess what? We go down a back a wall and back to an island place there. And then who couldn't go down a back a wall and back to run a country and them thing, they go up in some bush and hills, go live. And increase in numbers and in philosophy and ideas. So the 60s come after independence, 1 year. 1 year after independence, Jamaica said I'm independent from England. Then I'm going to try to get rid of Rasta again, 1963. And the atrocities that was placed upon Rasta in them days there. We weren't supposed to be there again. We weren't supposed to be there. Because the Mount of Rasta would get trim and trim themselves because of what was meted out to the Rastafari community. We weren't supposed to be there in a 63. We weren't supposed to be there. We were supposed to just fade away into obscurity. But guess what? 63, 3 years after Empire has come to Jamaica, they never witnessed nothing like that in a Jamaica. Never ever witnessed nothing like that in a Jamaica. And Rasta increased in numbers, 1966. And we got through. And see the nailing of the coffin, you know, where them the thing said, they got done Rasta totally. Them feel said, this now, I got done Rasta. Them say, Haile Selassie dead. And Haile Selassie dead, meaning say, no, okay, Rasta on the God dead. Can you remember, me used to live up at Red Hills, and I come in at the bus, the man, people mock with till if, hey, watch a man. If it was some bad man, his either will blow up the bus or something. The way the people them are mock with. Rasta on the God dead and this and this and all them something left. But guess what? You see, when them say Haile Selassie dead, check from 1970 until now and see that how much Rasta rise up in Jamaica, how much youth rise up and come say Emperor Haile Selassie the first and say them a Rasta. Them say Rastafari, even though when I sit on no religion, them say Rastafari garner more interest in Jamaica than the Roman Catholic Church. And you know, so Roman Catholic is the biggest Christian organization in the world, over a billion people under the Pope. Under the Pope, because him is a man of the cloth, and him wear enough cloth. And Rasta survived. Rasta survived to the point where in our culture and our cultural expression, it defined African people in a way where it was never defined in the Western world. We have been defining our consciousness and our reality and our move. That was, how did a little set of people in a little island like this come up with all these things? That the world now, the world, not just the Caribbean, and not just the Western world, but the world, look on Rastafari as a legitimate philosophy. And it has been able to move African people to a level of consciousness that they never see before. Because we march with Haile Selassie and we march with Marcus Garvey. Marcus Garvey as a, we would have called the father of Pan-Africanism. The political ideas of Marcus Garvey and the spiritual consciousness of Haile Selassie move Rasta to the next level. So we come with a cultural expression that was frightening and scary. But because we never give up that, and because we persistently continue with our levity, people start to find favor into what the Rastafari brethren and sisters was standing for. So when we look around us today, in the COVID-19 era, because it will go down as an era in human history, just like all the middle of the Black Plague, the First World War, the Second World War, just like how they have all sorts of things where they plague African people, just like how we have the Holocaust, the Black Holocaust. Now, Rastafari, levity, awareness and consciousness is on the lips
. While driving through Jamaica, there's only one radio station I listen to. IRFM.
I listen to everything on IRFM. IRFM on Sunday. IRFM on Monday. IRFM on Tuesday. IRFM on Wednesday.
On the lips.
On Friday is IRFM. On Saturday is IRFM. And you have a next day?
Yes, we are saying Rastafari catch them with the locks over the years, and the locks now has become a mainstay. The locks has become a mainstay in the cultural expression of not only in Jamaica but in the Western world. And we're not claiming locks because we know say, in Africa and in India, you didn't have locks man walk up and down. In Ethiopia, in Nigeria, you have locks people. In India, you didn't have locks people. But we are saying Rastafari has been able to maintain that cultural expression that catch the people them, especially African people, all over. And now we see the same slave master Pinckney now, a wear locks. And a ball out Rastafari. And we never fire no gun. We never fire no gun. We never threaten for bomb up nowhere. But through the philosophy and the cultural expression, we define ourselves. We define our people. Because Rastafari is about liberation and freedom for African people. And it's a black power movement with a spiritual nucleus. And it's the only movement in the Western world where black people define themselves, not only in a political way, but in a spiritual way. And then we come with a liberty, a certain liberty. And the liberty now is spread out, undeniable, undeniable. It takes root in a whole heap of youth, in a whole heap of people, and people now start to figure out and calculate. So we are saying, if we, the biggest thing of the earth, find ourselves in a situation now where we become the cornerstone of the building, where people were saying everything where we say a foolishness. And now them come realize a whole heap of things where we say it can go so, or so it go. What else will they come and say, Rasta, may I tell you the truth, you know? You don't know what that say all the while. You don't really know what that say. Because undeniable. Cause all we not go out with, you know. You don't know how to get with a Rasta. You don't know how to get with a Rasta. Yes. You don't know how to just suck it up, lip it up, cup it up. You don't know how to get with a Rasta. And may I believe you, me, Rastafari. Has given African people a new way of looking at themselves. Yes, new way of looking at themselves. So, no care what them want to say. We are going through with it. Yes. This is the Cutting Edge on IRFM. You know, we see all the things set. We see all the things set and we see a whole heap, we are talking about the Rastafari sequence and all, because we say Japanese come to Jamaica and take up residence in Jamaica and start to live like Rasta. We say Europeans come to Jamaica, take up residence in Jamaica and live like Rasta. Now, I have a problem with them hear the message and love the message, you know, but the greatest thing a white person who say them a Rasta can do, or a Japanese person who say them a Rasta can do, is go back to them country and tell them parents what them find out about the atrocities that was done against African people. And them in the position to do something about it. It's useless. You come at Jamaica, come at jump up and I talk about Rastafari and reggae music and Bob Marley, One Love and them top there, you know. And a Rasta that. That is half shoot of something. But I know Rasta that. Rasta is a philosophy that say liberation from oppression and white supremacy. So if you come claim where I did I say all of my life, and most ones in Jamaica who claim Rasta saying all of them life, and you come love it, the only thing you can do is go back to Europe and play reggae. The only thing you can do is go back and say you have a long locks and you go find out why you want to see you come on some elders and you go a bingy. I know you chant drum and a chant about rest of Africa, you want to go and all them something like. What is? Because you want to know, what we get enslaved with, the religion will enslave us. We, even stupid as it might be, take it for our own and carry it amongst our people and go spread it. We go spread the so-called Christianity amongst African people. Very misguided Africans who take it and then now make other Africans now change them lifestyle and change them ways and do something about it. So what we are talking about now, we are saying, if you get this message and you hear some people are cry out in Jamaica, say, look here, you see what them do to we? We are African people, you know, look how the French still are trying to colonize Africa. Look how white people still are got this and that. Look how Chinese people. And uno now come to Jamaica, come get all of that knowledge. And the only thing we can do is go back to Europe and go back to Japan, go play reggae. How that will reach on the family? Because most of them is them grandparents are the racists, you know. Maybe them not see racism like all them grandparents and see it, but guess what? It still maintain itself. It still maintain itself in all aspect. In all aspect of this order that them call globalization now leading up to the new world order. And when the new world order is in place, where is black people in all of that? No black people in all of that. It's some little white men sit down and construct that. And most of the little youth, them we are run up and down and talk about reggae, run love, run love. They're going to cut off them blacks and go back to them normal way of life. Just like going to the 60s, when they have the hippie them, I jump up and down all over the place and I take ash and I take this and I take that. Where them is now? A whole heap of them just seep into the society, you know, and become like the oppressors who them claim was oppressing the people them. There are no way to be found. Where have all the oppressed gone? The oppressed has become the oppressor. Where is the oppressed? And we see the same thing going on right now. That some group of little people are up and down in a Jamaican dub club and this, that, and Ray Ray and Lele and all them something like. And then little more, when push come to shove, you think they're going to stand up for our liberation. Every tub have to find him own bottom. You think they're going to stand up for our liberation. And it is nice for now, you know. It is nice, you know, but when the fire gets hot, when guys start to tell you about now, yes, we come through a world now, you know. One world. Everybody must go under that one world, that new world, that globalized world. Who you think going to run that world? Is the same youth them who come to Jamaica from Europe and Japan and these places. Is them mother and them grandparents going to run the world? So where you think them going to be? You think them going to run, come back to Jamaica and go sit down in some bush and talk about Rastafari, with all them can't see in front of them is suffering and poverty? Them going to take, you know, them cool, cozy place of abode and just be there, and we will still be here. Africa no have no friend. Africa no have no friend. We have to remember that, because right now, as we speak, they might test vaccination for an African in Africa. They might test vaccination for Africans in Africa. And them claim, say, Africa have the least amount as a continent. Africa have the least amount of COVID-19 cases. So how you go test for Africans? Wouldn't it be best if you go to Italy and test it? Or even America, who have the most death now, or England? I mean, I tell them not test none of them places, you know, but we understand how we know what them do with Africa as it relates to vaccination. And all these things. We know what them do. We understand how we know what them do with the Native American them. When them get the Native American, them blanket with smallpox in it. You don't believe me, go figure that out. Go look, check on the history. Them send blanket in the Native American community with smallpox in it. When you go look in at the Tuskegee experiment we mentioned all the while, this is history. Google it and see the Tuskegee experiment and you will see that white people create a situation where them inject syphilis in about 300 African people at test them system as it relates to that. And it's years after President Clinton apologized for it, because once again, it's a woman, it's a nurse, go find out this the thing where them do in the hospital, the Tuskegee experiment. Google it and you will see what we are talking about. Them inject rat with virus for going at the black community because see how immune the African people them will be against the virus in the black community. Them put anthrax in a t-shirt in a South Africa and issue it out to the black people, them, especially the ANC, anthrax. They make, hey, it might sound weird what we are talking about, you know, but it is written in history. As a matter of fact, the doctor of death, I will keep saying this over, I will keep repeating the same thing. Look here. Them have a man who is still alive right now. I walk up along South Africa. Them call him the doctor of death. Him come in front of the Truth and Reconciliation Tribunal where Bishop Tutu is set up in South Africa. For all the people them, forget forgiveness, must come forward and admit what them do. This man get up in the court, a white man get up in the court and admit, say, him create a disease will only affect black people. Only black people in South Africa it affects. It now got affect white people. And him still a walk up and down in South Africa because him get what? Forgiveness. But we don't forget. We don't forget. And we know, say, the mindset of these people, and yet still we have ones and ones, youth and youth all over Europe now. Reggae is them thing. Them jump up and down. Reggae music. And then now you have the reggae artists. Them nah, it's not a serious thing. It's not a limited thing them I work with. You know, see, it's not like them go there for show these youth, say, look here. Hell, we got through for how much years, you know. And watch out, we are telling us, say, it's not like we come here to come look friend, but we are no say, since uno day so, uno must do something. If uno really feel the strength, if uno really feel that is a just cause the Rasta man has stand up for in Jamaica, anywhere the Rasta there, uno speak truth to power. That's what uno must do, speak truth to power. And if you don't do that, trust me, it's terrible.
So China's kind of back to work. The lockdown has been lifted. The epicenter, Wuhan, is apparently reporting no new cases. And apparently, the Chinese method is the only method that has proved successful. This should be good news. But good news from China, or for that matter, any news from China, meets with a problem. The problem of credibility. Can China's coronavirus recovery be trusted? It feels a bit odd to be even asking this question. The world still doesn't have an answer to the many, many questions that we've asked of China. Repeatedly, for more than 3 months now, questions about the source of the virus, the cure, the research, the reopening of the wet markets, no answers at all. So we keep asking the questions and we take the good news from China with a sack of salt. Tonight, I want to raise five questions, five very basic, simple questions for China to answer. I'll try to keep them as direct as possible. Question number one, where did the Wuhan virus come from? The coronavirus come from? China says it wasn't Wuhan. For a while, the Chinese blamed the Americans, but now they have made a U-turn. So where did the virus come from? It's very important to know. Was it the wet markets? which the Chinese government strangely hasn't shut down. If yes, then we must be preparing for another pandemic, a COVID-21 or 22, God forbid. Did it originate because of sloppy practices in Chinese labs, which is even worse? In any law-abiding country, those who recklessly pursue hazardous activities are held accountable, even punished for such disasters. In China, all of this is buried under the carpet. So that's the first question they must answer, the origin of the virus. Question number two. How has China cured the positive cases at home? Again, no one knows. Why do I ask? Because China had reported more than 82,000 cases. Let's assume that is the right figure. Now, China says 90% of these cases have been cured. The question is how? What are they using? Is it traditional Chinese medicine, which President Xi also seems to be promoting? Or is it that nanomaterial that Global Times reported about? If yes, why not share it with the world? Perhaps learn from India. Hydroxychloroquine is not even a proven cure. It's a potential cure. And India has exported 14 million tablets of it. It is gifting paracetamol to neighbors and many life-saving drugs to nations in peril. What has China done? Donation diplomacy, and that too backfired. China exported faulty masks and test kits. If China had cured tens of thousands of people, it claims it has, it should tell the world how and spare us the test kits. Question number three, where does research stand in China? I ask because China is very quick in slamming anything that anyone else proposes. Hydroxychloroquine is ineffective, said China, but it has offered no alternatives. It should, because it had a clear head start. It had the first samples, which it destroyed or hid. It reported the first case in December 2019. It's been almost 4 months now. China boasts of the world's biggest research labs. What are they doing? We won't know because China is clamping down on the publication of coronavirus research. Any academic papers on the virus will not be published until they receive a green light from the special task force of the State Council. Believe it or not, a special task force for research. The Chinese censors must clear everything. Question number four. Why doesn't China give access to international experts if it has nothing to hide? China says it's a collective challenge. Fine, global experts want to share their knowledge, make a collective effort. Why is China not accepting those offers? A WHO delegation was sent to Wuhan, but then we do not know what it found. In any case, the WHO has lost much credibility since. The US Center for Disease Control has offered to send experts to China. Beijing denied. The question is why? What is China hiding? And the last and most pertinent question. Can China assure the world that this will not happen again? Will China shut its wet markets? After all, knowing how a pandemic started is key to stopping the next one. And China's wet markets have been the birthplace of many diseases. There have been warnings, scientific warnings. But these markets have gone back to selling exotic meat. From deer to minks to foxes, bats and pangolins, they're all back on the plate. What assurance, if any, can China give the world? Instead of answering the questions, though, China holds a light show to celebrate and divert attention. Well, we will not be blinded by these lights. The questions will continue. It is important to hold China accountable and make China pay.
Yes, may I tell you, it's a serious thing, you know. It's a serious thing. So, a virus was unleashed. And now the whole world feeling the spike of it. And that is where it is now. So we need some answers because you have so much arguments going around. But somebody know the truth, a group know the truth. And that is really where the people are searching for the truth. Because do we always see this thing, you know, it look like it's got there for a long while. And when we say for a long while, I mean like oh, flu there. Can you just imagine how January will start over this again? What a thing, because you know, people, and Jamaican people, with all the beautiful highways and roads, hardly any car drive upon it now. With all the whole heap of building them we have go. All anybody has sit down in them now. So things go. Because these things were supposed to show you how progressive we are and prosperity is booming. But look where they know. We're going to the base thing now, the base thing. The road them is hardly being used again. All the pretty road them I make. Me drive go a Manor Park and I come up 6 o'clock. Trust me, man. Me I tell you, the place clear. We look upon all the building them now, them empty, everybody, the parking space them in the building them now, empty. You can't go play football in them now. Yeah, man, you can't go play basketball in the parking space them now. But then you can't go play because them tell you, say, certain amount of people must find themselves in a crowd. So you have to go to your yard. May I tell you? You have some man there in them yard now, and them would never even know, say, them kitchen did have an electric stove, right? Them would ask them wife, and when you buy an electric stove, she'll tell them, say, they know when me get married, we'll get it as a gift. And they married all 10 years, and she never see it yet. Say that the tune that you just hear is a tune by a lady named Barbie Gay, we'll say it again. It is the original version, not a version, it's the original tune that was given to Millie Small by Chris Blackwell. And Millie Small take that song and make it become hers. That it went on to sell millions of copies and put her upon the map as the first Jamaican woman to become so international that it sell over or maybe 6 million copies. And I want to remind you that the first million selling album ever in the history of albums was done by a Jamaican named Arabella Fante. Arabella Fante, the first million selling album. Well, in the 60s, this little girl, as she was at the time, took this tune that we just play named My Boy Lollipop and make it become hers. That I know that a whole lot of people hearing that when we just play, I say, why Muta play the version? Because that doesn't sound like Millie Small. Well, it is not Millie Small. It is not Millie Small. It's a lady named Barbie Gay. And she did the original version of My Boy Lollipop. So here is the original version of My Boy Lollipop. Yes. We have said the original version of this, but you are now. It come like the original version of this. Yeah, it come like the original version of this, because as I say, most people don't know the original version. And we know so outside in a radio land, you know, people are saying, I'm a motor, say, this is the original version. But we know what we are saying. We are saying, this is a cover version that did much, 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 much more than what the original version did. Yeah, Millie Small. Millie Small coming through. This is the cutting edge on RFM. And, you know, we change gear now. We are talking about something different now. We are talking about Millie Small. Millie Small passed away Tuesday. At 73 years old. Now, I know that most people who are listening to this program they might not have known or even hear about Millie Small, but them hear about My Boy Lollipop. Because I remember Bounty Killer did cover it with her sister. and people start to lick his bounty killer. I'm talking about my boy Lollipop. I have a brother in the studio, no guy, I call him say Lollipop, you know. I would tell him some brethren. Be not call him a Lollipop, you know. Because him find it pleasurable to say him a Lollipop. And this tune will make him even feel better now when he hear the girl and say, my boy Lollipop. But back to Millie Small. Millie Small that sings from she a little girl before she a teenager. We want you love xylophone, you know. We want you love xylophone because xylophone that sing from she a little girl, just like Marcia Griffiths. And all that, most of the singers them will come out 40 years after you hear them is the best Jamaican, and they have done so much for Jamaica. But Millie Small started from she a little girl, and she went on to do other songs, even though the other songs was not popular internationally as My Boy Lollipop, but she did make a mark. Did make a mark.
While driving through Jamaica, there's only one radio station I listen to. Iria FM. Iria FM. Iria FM. Iria FM.
Did make a mark. She did make a mark out there. Did make a mark. She did make a mark out there.
Yes. This is the Cutting Edge on IRFM. We just featuring a little thing about Millie Small, who passed on Tuesday at 73 years old in England. She lived in England long, 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 long time. You know, the last time I was doing an IRFM broadcast in London, we did try to get her to come on the program. Yeah, as a matter of fact, we did line up everything, but she just never come. She just never come. And she never come back to Jamaica. You know how much people try to get her to come to the show down here? Yeah? Enough people get her to come to the show down here. Yeah? Remember all Heineken Star Time and all them show there. They try to get her. Because you know most ones who they don't make it in the music business, the singer them go to England. We can't talk about Alton Ellis, we can talk about Jimmy Cliff, we can talk about Dennis Brown, Millie Small, you know, Owens, Willie Padem end up in England, you know, and Rod Shirley was the one where, as a matter of fact, him do a Heineken Star Time and it never ever take a year after or a couple months after we hear same pass away. You know, Alton Ellis, the day of England, come forward still. You know, we know of woolly parties that go to England and still. Well, she was the one who go to England and never come back. And she goes live all the other places, some far country. She go live. And she just didn't know now. The name of Millie Small will echo in the halls of Jamaican music as one of the icons, even though it's a one-hit wonder internationally. She made her mark where nobody, no female in Jamaican music has done. Yeah, I am told that she sells 6 million like My Boy Lollipop. In a them time there, they say 6 million record, you know, say a big superstar, you know. Yeah, anytime she go anywhere, you know, me I tell you, paparazzi and everybody just a flash, 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 flash. Because of one song. All she didn't need is one song. And if you check most artists, you know, most artists, you see that one song where they make, and they make other songs. You see, if they don't do that one song there, them better run off of the stage. I remember when Nina Simone come to Jamaica, that time Young, if she done black, they like kick up hell. And then put her in an arena, and she did there sing, 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 and all she sing, nobody don't know the song that she sing. Them want to hear, young if you don't black, or my baby don't care for me. And the woman there they are singing, and me, I tell you, the mount a cup when I fly upon the stage. Paper cup that was. The mount a cup when fly upon the stage. The woman just walk off, because she no ramp, you know. She no ramp. But it's a one song thing there. The one, you have a brother named Carl Douglas, you know, he have a tune name, Kung Fu Fighting. Everybody was Kung Fu Fighting. Nobody, a whole lot of people don't know that Jamaica that did that tune there, you know. But guess what? If you might do a concert, I don't know that song there, you know, it come like the promoter will take back their money. And same way like Count Prince Miller, who go to England go live, with the mule train, mule train. That one song there. You think him say could have, you think him could have got to a concert and not do that song there? Well, Stone reach him. Yeah, man. So that one song can do many things for you. And it is good when you have another song to complement that song. How beautiful it is when somebody can have more than one song. I tell you.
It's called Patient 31. And this story comes out of South Korea.
Okay.
Patient 31.
Okay.
35-year-old Chinese woman flew into South Korea. Mm-hmm. All right. She flew into South Korea feeling absolutely fine.
Okay.
On February 6th, she was in a minor car accident in South Korea.
Okay.
She took herself to the hospital and she was fine. No major accidents or bones broken or anything like that. However, she had a slight temperature, and they wanted to test her. She said, no, I'm fine. I'm not sick. I'm fine. I want to go. She left. Okay? She then attends church. She goes to church on February 9th, and she goes to church on February 16th.
Okay.
Okay? Right after that, her symptoms started to come. All right? That's a long gap between her feeling fine.
Yeah.
And then the symptoms coming.
Yeah.
Doctors advise her to check immediately for the coronavirus. She gets tested. And she's got it.
Oh, man.
Just prior to the testing, she went to a hotel and had a buffet lunch.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay. So she's gone to two churches.
Yep.
And she's now had a buffet lunch at a hotel, which so many people can do.
Yep.
Which is just a regular day. 2 days, she gets all the symptoms, and they officially make her patient 31 in South Korea.
Right.
Her alone,
mm-hmm.
that one person,
mm-hmm.
patient 31, created approximately 60% of all cases in South Korea.
60%?
60 stem from patient 31.
Who was a 35-year-old woman who said she felt fine.
Who was, yep, went on with her day.
And went to all the places.
1,200 people
mm-hmm.
were infected who were at the church. Those two masses.
Wow.
1,200 got infected, right?
From her.
From her. Because, and then some of them went to a funeral. So infected the people at the funeral, and it was a domino effect.
Well, of course, they all have families, friends.
So out of the total 8,897 infected in South Korea, this patient 31, unfortunately, created 5,382 of those.
That just blew my mind.
That is patient 31, and that is the story that we need to understand.
Give thanks to Nigel. Nigel works somewhere else. Who are tell Nigel, say, give thanks. Because what we are using is where we usually play out with a party. And him turn it in a radio station. We not stop saying that. Him turn me things them, all the things that I used to play out with. My mixer, my console, my this, my that, my computer, all the things them. Now it's turn a radio station. Give thanks for that. This is what you call internet radio. I forget that name, you know. I go for give it a name. Maybe we should have called it Shane FM. But the struggle continue because now we see the war a fight and the enemy is unseen with the naked eyes. Unseen with the naked eyes, but We know say dead still. Like the breeze. We know say dead. We hope say the people them are take heed. We see the thing fly gone. I mean, really fly. Especially in the Kingston, you saw. And send catch anything. It fly, man, me I tell you. 200 odd people from one place. My gosh, man. It look like a company that do a killer people. Because what them did I do over there, so? I mean, really. Oh, I mean, that for sure say nothing, no protocol, no in that place at all. It's either the people, the boss and management put up protocol there, the youth them just decide, say, oh, how would them attack them for damn foolish, you say? I remember originally them attack, they say, young people now catch it. And now where we look at it, most of young people are catch it. Remember when I tell you about black, them have a little theory really that go around, say, the reason why Africa not have so much height is because of the sun, and we're near the sun, and we're melanin skin. Now, most of the people them in America will catch it. Per capita is black people. So all of these things made null and void. I will not say everyone away is capable. So we have to just try our best to do the thing right. And we kind of see the people them are trying, you know. Yeah, but you know, it's true, you know, use to something. True, you know, use to something. You really know why. You know, when you know use or something, it really come away for you really go by the thing. And then when you go by that thing, it's hard to really keep it up. Because keeping it up is not something where you're used to. So when a man says social distance, you really want to keep the social distance, but there's something that you're not checking. Like me, I look on some line in some outside of one bank, two bank. And the people, them are lined up for going there, you know, but everybody they on them phone. And you don't know when the person move, but when they move, you're trying to move closer. And you realize, sometimes when that person is in the front
now,
of your
last
move,
week, I had you write an essay about the things that you like the most.
Because the social distance is 6 feet for the matter. I don't know 6 feet from nobody, you know. Hey, watch out. A tree of my hand length from one hand to the next, you must stay stand up and talk to me. I see a brethren run, come on my car, you know. At this week, this evening, yeah. I see a man run, come on my car, you know, and I'm talking. And I don't really want to disrespect him still for winding up my glass, because I'm going to say, hey, you see them boy there. But you see, all him know, him can't figure out and say, social distance is something we're on. I'm carrying thing about that. So you have to just let him down easy. Because if you're going to do the thing where you're supposed to do, you're going to hear, oh, you had this and oh, you had that, and oh, I saw no treat people on the road and all of that, and I treat nobody on the road. It's just that him not do what I'm supposed to do. And you conscious of what you're supposed to do. You know, it's a weird thing. It's a weird thing when a woman have hot flash in her crowd. I know you used to she have coronavirus because she have hot flash and she has sweat. That is the weirdest one I hear. You have hot flash and now you are accused of coronavirus. Is like an accusation, you know. And this might sound ridiculous still, but here one, may I suggest something, you know. May I suggest something for actually make the social distance work, especially in the bank, the man them thing. I'm gonna see a bank do it, you know. You see, instead of you make the people them farm line, we don't know how expensive it is. But maybe you could have give them some chair. Set the chair them six feet, them say, 6 feet apart. May I talk about outside? Set the chair them 6 feet apart. And make the people them use that as a line. That means say you don't stand up outside and wait. Because you know sometimes you wait long. What you do is put seat there. And social distance them with the seat 6 feet apart. You social distance them. But I say every 6 feet you put a seat there. Especially for the elders them. Because you have some elders now, even though they put the elders them in the next line. But it's very difficult for them to stand up there and wait till two people go in and come out, and the next two people come out. Maybe should have some seat and put the seat 6 feet apart. We don't know that sound, but people are doing it already. Instead, they put a spot on the ground. Because people now watch spot on the ground, you know. But if they must sit down, they must keep themselves at one place longer than if they must stand up. Because when you stand up, you get fidgety. Especially when the line have to move. You move closer to the person in front of you. If you put the seat on the seat stationary, when a man get up out of that seat there, and the next man go in at the seat, you understand? I don't know. People could have said no, but Muta, the man go in at the seat and have it. Yeah, but if you see a man cough and a man sneeze in a seat, you're not going to sit down there. Even if they don't have it still. But we just say that if a man now sneeze and a man now cough, and him go sit down there. Because me see people that come downstairs and hold up and railing, staircase railing. And that is really a problem. For a hold up and the staircase railing. You know what I mean? Eh? Me see people that come out an elevator and I press the button with them finger. And people that go through the door in a bank. And I hold the bank door, and I, you know, thousands of people hold the bank door before you. Yeah, man. So, me don't know. Them catch you in some little level here where we have to think. We have to outthink the virus. Yeah, it's a. We come to this now where we have to outthink virus. The virus is not a living thing, you know. Who didn't know that? You know, so the virus is not a living thing. A virus is a virus, you know, it's not a germ, it's not a disease, it's a virus, you understand? But we have to try all things, something that is not alive. It is not alive, and we have to figure out how to pop it. I can't do it, Jamaica, like I said, pop your fool, sleep your fool, you know what I mean? This is the cutting edge at IRFM. She know me years an advertisement on the part of the program again, Rasta. No, we don't understand that. Oh, we don't get an advertisement on the minute. I mean every 15 minutes for the staff. Talk to me, Shane. Talk to me. Oh, we don't get an advertisement on the part of the radio again. Eh?
Well, at the same thing, me here to you don't move to about, yeah, man, we have ads, is it?
Better lose track of what we're going to say now through the only bad words. Come like holiday for stepping the cutting edge. I want them to hear me. If that, say that.
Yeah, man, may I hear you, man? You have an exit yeah. Coming up.
I tell you, I mean, like, from the program start, we don't stop your ads. We don't know. We hear say, ads God, dog, 15 minutes, every minute, 15 minutes. And them not, it's so like holiday, it's so like when Christmas are come. We I tell you, man, anyway, we don't pressure for that. But you know what I say now? We don't talk about the seating thing and the arrangement with the seat them in a certain business place where you go. For the elders them, especially when them outside, you put some chairs 6 feet apart and make them sit down. Because sometimes they're really out there long. I mean, I watch, I like I mean, I know, me is one of them young elders, so me can't stand it more time, you know, see it. So, and then me now, I'm going to go, they're going to stand up near the line, from me to the line to the line, me drive off. Me go somewhere else, you know, come here, make sure I have all three, four things for do. Me not left my yard for one thing, especially a bank thing. I go to the bank today and I say, Rachel, you see the thing when I talk about banking from home? Put that on my phone. You don't see it? Because I'm not that foolish. You say, because tell them to lie, Douglas. So. Understand? And if Amazon did that, do like what they do in America, where, like, Whole Foods, you order your food and then bag it for you and send it to my yard by June, right at your doorstep, you know? Them still come a yard by June. It's a June come a yard and drop all of your health food, this and your health food, that and them things. If that is about the place, more but you have some youth who are innovative now, will start them something there in Jamaica, you know, where you can order your produce and them deliver it to you, deliver your yard. But me don't know if them downtown, they may go drive, come clear up here, so. Because me, I tell you, which part me live is like, them would have drive go Ochi. They would have drive so far. Anyway, but it's a good idea, the innovations, when we see a go on amongst the youth them, you know, delivery, food delivery, you know, deliver your food, you can deliver your grocery if you want, if an elder want grocery for buy, them come get the list and just do, I want to yell up my daughter, I want to yell up my daughter, you know, yeah, I she recognize where I go on and she just say, send me the list. I may just send her the list and she don't ever come in on my house or come in on my yard. She stand up at the gate and I don't want she come in either. Me don't want she come in. She stand up at the gate and give me the things them. And sometimes she say, when I say, how much she come up to, she says, all right. And that part that is sweet. When she says, all right. I say, it's all right, me don't mind it. And me just take it, make a habit now. Me say, you're going to the supermarket again or you're going to the market. Just use the same list you had given before. Just use the same list you had given before. Because it's amazing. It's amazing when you reach this age, what can be done for you. But then again, I used to do for them when them was my age, and they will never be my age. When they are their age, and I am saying, I did many things, so it's a payback. I love the payback, though, but it is nice of her to think of me that way and our parents that way, you know what I mean? Really, that's what children are for. You know, and we never know what I get in this situation, yeah? Never know. So what I get in this situation, yeah? Because right now, people is getting crazy in them house, man. What if a people is getting house sick? Them want to leave them house. Them want to come out, you know? You look on the WhatsApp and you look on this and that, you see people start to get frustrated. You better make this thing be seasonal. Because if any of be seasonal, it will be mad people, you see the place. They were talking about build up back economy and them something. If you start to build up this economy at December, you hear say, Wong Hun in China, it come back and them something. Oh my gosh, man. I tell you. Your body has a boy debt. You run to the rock and the rock need a hiding place for itself. And that will happen. But we're glad to see most people will catch it now dead. That is the beauty of this thing, yeah. We're glad to see most people who catch it is not dying. And we have to emphasize that most people who have it. And we are talking about Jamaica now. Most people who have it, not going to dead. A whole heap of them, you, the 200 people, when you see catch it in a St. Catherine. Most of them, you, if any, them not going to die. Now, I couldn't know that. So don't bother keep down on the spirit and make them feel like say, the end of the world. Most of the ones, them who catch it over, where them call the place, where Alwal, something like that. So BPO building, we're going to open back. We're not going to leave it out. We're not going to leave it out. Tell anybody, say, Muta, say that. Don't you think that if you don't come amongst me, Muta might not leave it out. I'm doing that them joke. So if you don't know, so you used to work over there and have it, don't come on my yard. Don't call to me by the street, because you're going to call to me and keep me catch it. You understand? But me just say, we're not going to leave it out. We're not going to leave it out. Don't worry on yourself. I mean, we're not going to worry still, but the excessive worry make us sick more. Because then we might hear something dead from else. Where is your African pride? That's the question. Where is your African pride? And that is really where we are work with you now. Because a whole heap of the sister them really now work with African pride. Not working with it at all. I don't know why. You see, you have to go back to that, you know. You have to go back to that. You could have fingernail a little more. You could have eyelash a little more. You could have bleach a little more. You have to go back to it. And do what you want, your woman. Take charge of your life. Say you don't need a man, tell your husband. Make up your mind, you can do whatever you choose to do. And every time you put your clothes on and get ready for this world, make sure you put your best foot first. Yeah, this is... What are you saying?
Yeah, yes, Muta.
We owe you, man, Mandingo.
Yes, and I just say, you could have been a little bit more than can change them race. And then better get used to the idea to be proud of them African teachers.
Oh, you know what I mean? I know it's going to show up on them.
Yes. You know?
Serious. So, oh, England, man. England.
This education. And we just remember how Millie Small as the first Jamaican who sell over a million records in Britain by buying lollipop.
Yes. I just played the original version a while ago.
Eh?
You know the original version, right?
Yeah, by Bobby Gale. Yes, man.
I just played it a while ago.
In 1957, but not.
Yeah.
But not like the Millie Small.
No, nothing like it. Definitely. Yeah, I mean, it was. Anyway, you hear about them Jamaicans, they will come down today. Or today or tomorrow.
No.
Yeah, them have a plane load of Jamaicans that come to Jamaica. Including some of them are on the boat. You know about it?
Some of them were there.
What that was on the boat. You remember the government never did allow some Jamaicans
The one on the boat that took ship and to go to Portugal.
Well, some of them end up in England. The boat did end up in England.
Yes, I end up in England. Portugal then end up in Southampton, England. Yes.
So we are going in England there because we hear say, hopeless or no terrible.
Put on them, you know.
No, me hear say, hopeless or terrible. What? With the corona.
Yes. Because it's almost it's over 29,000 dead so far in Britain here from the coronavirus, which states make the USA and Britain having the most deaths from coronavirus.
So-called
first world countries.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Can't believe that.
What caused it here? Yes. Because what happened, what caused it here is that for 5 weeks, Boris Johnson and his cronies did not prepare the medical facilities and so on to deal with preventing so many deaths.
Yeah.
He took it serious in terms of hospital facilities, PPEs, and so on. And a lot of our people who died disproportionately as Africans is because then they have frontline services treating people who have coronavirus, yes, because
you know, say most of the people them will catch it and bring it come to Jamaica, England, them that come from.
Yes. Well, that case of the lady who came to that funeral in Bull Bay.
Yeah, the first one.
Because what was happening is that Boris Johnson was still allowing people to come into the country without testing them. And all that means, without testing them.
Yeah.
And never put in place, testing inside the country too. Yes, to deal with things, yes. And what happens is that a lot of our African people, due to institutional and individual racism, by them die so disproportionately as doctors and nurses and so, is because they are on the front line actually tending to the patients while then European counterparts are in a managerial position due to racism, you know, whereby our people qualify, but they don't get the promotion to be managers. That is what happens in the medical field as in other fields, you know.
Well, hope that it's not seasonal.
Yes, because that's the next thing. Because what they're saying is that you're in a situation whereby them say that if you get it one time, it don't mean that you won't get it again, which bears in line with your point. Say, let's hope that it's not seasonal too.
What a thing.
You know, it's a really, really serious thing. And, you know, me really have to commend the governments in the Caribbean and in Africa that have managed to keep the level of debt down so far. And we see in Madagascar, they have some herbal thing.
Yeah, but they must say
some plan, which then say help it, yes, which prevent it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, they might go around it, though. The world health people, they might go around it.
Yes, the WHO will try put it down to say it's not guaranteed or that thing, but nobody has died in Madagascar.
Nobody not dead.
And despite having cases, yes. And I don't like all the GAA, Andrew Warren's regime, or them refuse the Cuban medicine, which has been affected, interferon. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And
puppet on a string, brethren. Puppet on a string.
It's the life of our people. You know what I mean?
Puppet on a string.
So. Yes. You know.
Anyway, we give thanks.
Yeah, give thanks. I'm going to pick up Ernest Rackman, the genius guitarist, because
My boy Lollipop.
I'm playing the My Boy Lollipop.
Yes, of course. Yeah, man. Give thanks, Virgin. You know? Irie.
Yes.
May I tell you?
Yes.
This is the cutting edge. And Irie FM, the thing say, we are around. Jesse Jenner, I say, I'm gone up. A compound, but on Maroon, you know, and sitting with them. I don't know.
Okay, well, I really big up Jesse still, you know, because Jesse is a great one, you know.
Okay.
Hope him get better soon, you know.
Yeah, well, we hope so too. So, who are they behind that?
Who are the soldiers like this and this time, you know?
Yeah, so who talk to me?
The last time we talked, I just said you can call me the Great King.
I must call you the Great King?
Yes, man.
Why? Why I must call you the Great King?
Well, you shall see, you know.
No, just tell me, no, because I can't see you up on the phone. I ask you why I must call you the Great King.
So I tell you, you know that me never really mean to see me on the phone, you know. You know I understand me. I understand you.
Just tell me. Why we must call you the Great King?
Oh, boy.
What have you done to deserve being called a Great King?
Good question, Mota.
Answer it, man.
You can listen to Garnet Silk, give me answer you for the time.
No, really, Garnet Silk is dead. May I ask you, why me must call you Great King? Are you say you're Great King, and I must call you Great King, you know? May I ask you, why me must call you so?
And I said I don't really manifest.
All right, Megan, hear everything. You can't take the foolishness. Megan.
Of Selassie, no, trodden in a Babylon, chanting Rastafari song, though the road is rough.
not for long. Still we're gonna hold up strong. Behold, a son of the Almighty. You can control the children of Selassie I. The children of Selassie I. They try to live up.
Hello.
Yeah, yeah.
God bless it, man.
Oh, Muta?
Yeah, man, I'm Muta, man.
Oh, Muta fan about 2 Wednesdays, and I try to forget your star.
Remember, never I take no call 2 Wednesdays ago.
Eh?
I wasn't calling 2 Wednesdays. I wasn't taking call 2 Wednesdays ago.
I understand, but Mr. Fan, last week, I have 2 points to say to you. I don't know if I have enough credit to say to you. So I call fans.
Well, say one of them, not said one of them. Since I 2 years, I've said one.
Oh, the first one, I went and did a talk to black people and on friend Muta.
African have no friend, I don't say.
Yeah, I agree with you 100% when I said that the night. You see, okay. Me laugh and me weed choke me. You see, you're going to
make me laugh now till my corona choke me.
No, I never tell another something about corona, see, but I tell about the said point. You talk to boy, all kind of people so humiliated. You see, I say, can't realize we are gone. You see, so I have bonus cliff. You see, I say, when I talk that and I talk to most of my brothers, I bust out that. Bust out a laugh and the weed choke me.
You well, me you cough? You did cough?
Yeah, me not on Kyrola. I cough me after the weed choke
me. No, oh, you know you ain't have it. Oh, you know you have it. Oh, you know you have it.
No, but I mean, I isolate myself straight from people, man. Me not have
what?
It.
What? I think I don't. What? You can't catch
it. I know that thing with it, Muta. Otherwise, for that, I'm going to tell people and I'm friend. You swear me, I say, me have another pint. You see, this Kyrola thing, people are disrespect people over this Kyrola thing, and then disrespect
of
over
course.
This too. That's what I say.
Yeah, man, people are throw people out of the bus now, throw them car.
You see, not only that, you see, come, me have a thing to say, but me only say something tomorrow. More to say, me can call tomorrow to say it.
Call me tomorrow and tell me.
You see, so.
Give me a preview away, like I go say. No, give me a preview away, like I go say.
Oh, me, I said, in a center, myself, we know, you have no case, have no corona, more than one, when me hear from mostly one of the bathroom. You see, so one girl, one year, we did a work, in a my district, we did a work at the call center, one little young girl. You see, so the girl come home, and have not, and the people might discriminate against the people, against the girl and her family. And not,
terrible.
Not in a, then put me in a, and then say, I'm me, I go buy something for the people, then we have corona. You swear me, I said. Me got a road and I deal with people and that. You swear me, I say people that tell me, say, boy, then I'm not with me, because then you say, I'm going to buy something for the people and we have car order. And the girl, people then have nothing, man, the girl have must underlying condition and they don't know nothing. More than the police come and ray, and the people in place. You see, they put me hard on this thing. You see, it was nothing about, and then the people then have no car order. You see, boy, and the girl did that work and they come check out with them to check. You swear me, I say, and people, I say, and me, I go buy something for the people and we have car.
Yeah, you said that you said about 5 times already.
Yeah.
So where you go to now? Where you go to?
No, me just have me only. I said, boy, I want to send fan where they me vexed over the idea when me ear. So me I said, I want to talk it over the ear. Me people
yeah, man.
Know to them to stop dealing with certain things. And this is the case. And where's the fan? No, gossip. But the people,
me agree with you.
You see, I'll face with me as a people gone fan. I disrespect the people and I talk where they're supposed to talk. I ain't right, Bridget. You see, so
I agree with you.
I'm a vex. You see, so that's how I go up on the air from where they, it happened, and boy, I tell you, I'm a vex. Bad.
Are you glad taking it for company this. Here now, don't you?
You see, eh?
You're glad taking it for company here now?
Yes, ma'am. The only side standing tomorrow where we are there with the moon.
No, they don't get a call tomorrow.
The Jamaica
no,
can hear.
Yeah, hold on. No, this is better night.
Call for me now.
Yo.
You see? I'm going to want to hear the more the next report from Center Mass too.
You know, you hear me I say, you know?
Mm,
I
say, yeah,
don't respect the night, you know? A whole heap of people are listening.
I listen.
Especially Center Mass.
Mm. Yeah, so I'm going to hear about the next report about Center Mass because people are talking this and that and that, but I have to know me here about more than one case. You see, in the past.
Yeah. All right, sir.
So anyway,
I don't act up yourself.
I Google things from Center Martin and I third time on my call from your program.
It's
a long time. Yeah, man. You see,
where you so call for the first time?
Where I do. You see? I just love the thing where I deal with.
Yeah, you but see? You remember I say no.
Yeah.
You remember you didn't say you can't talk two things. Now you talk five things and I talk more, right? Your credit no don't steal.
Then I'm an idle man, so I wouldn't mind talking to you for long, man. What do you say, man? Yeah, I'm a big
yeah, but other people, booster, man. You see, I'm the first move on the phone.
You know, man.
You know. Keep your weight name there, your credit. That in case tonight you start to sneeze.
No.
Keep the credit that you call somebody.
Yeah. Anyway, me can I say that something more, huh?
If your credit now, don't say it.
Anyway, me always talk about the African country, them. You see me saying Africa.
Yeah.
But then go on, like, say, boy. Not now, go on, but let me tell you, sir, where did I Google Zimbabwe and Botswana?
Zimbabwe? Where you call it? Zimbabwe?
Zimbabwe.
Oh, Zimbabwe, okay.
Yeah, and Botswana, European them places. But you can in them places, turn up, Reginald, I'm pretty.
Turn up. Yeah, man, that's true, man.
Yeah, man, them places turn up Beijing. So I don't go like an African country now improve and economy not strong.
That's your business.
You see. They might go
like Rwanda the fastest right. Love that. Kind of mean of the world, you know.
You see.
Anyway, take care of yourself here, Beijing. Muta in the rainforest. I hope in the area going behind me, you know. My friend them, they behind there loud and clear. You know? Yes. The things them they behind there. Anyway, next car, Yel.
Yel Muta.
How you do?
Yeah.
You have to talk louder, do you know?
Yeah, I hear me now.
Yeah, man, I hear you.
Yeah, man. Years, I've been wanting to talk to you still, you know. Long time.
Years?
Yeah, man.
You're serious? That means you're not serious then. You're not serious.
Yeah, man, I'm serious, man. I come all the lifetime achievement award, me ethical.
You talk to me?
I never really get for easy with it still.
Yeah. All right, make you sight then, or where you want to talk about? Tell me.
That's a thing since night. I say them a test vaccine in Africa.
Them a test what?
The vaccine in Africa.
You hear me say that them a test vaccine? Me say yeah. Them say them test vaccine in Africa and I go and like say Africa have it.
Oh, catch you. Me a hear a Indian man, a medical Indian man. I say him can't allow that to happen in Africa because Africa.
Yeah.
So
well, them have them little sneaking way for going around there and have some African leader have big money for do it, you know.
Yeah, true, that's still.
Yeah, because a Frenchman, the first time I hear it, such as it was a Frenchman, I hear it, such as it.
Two of them are discussing.
Yeah, the two of them attack, yeah.
The boy, this is the first place in my life to test that thing.
And them are smile when them are say it too, you know.
Yeah, and Africa have the least.
Yeah.
But me I say no, Muta. Now the development of Africa, Rwanda, one of the prettiest places in the world.
It's the fastest rising economy right now.
Yeah, true.
I can't wait them and say.
The president, the Parker gave me, I watched an interview with him the other day, when I talked to the rest of the leader, them say, them no need to go to Europe, to get Europe teaching and understanding, to come back to Africa, come stop them. Fix our own problem within the people.
Of course.
And spirituality.
Yeah.
And that man,
well, brethren, I can tell you something. The African leader, them are wake up, you know, but you have some of them, they were stubborn, you know. We're just stuck in the European way that it is pressure, man. Pressure.
A true father, man. A true attack. Yeah.
But it's a workout still, you know. It's a workout, man.
You can't go so one way forever and ever and ever.
No.
Take time.
Can't go so.
And I listen to the program since night. I hear play a lollipop song by Millie Small. But I hear play the original version by Barbie.
Yeah, Barbie Gray.
Yeah. I never know say it was the original version.
That's why I play it to make people know. Are
you? I know that. I Google it immediately. Immediately, I Google it, Dad. I swear. Yeah, man. You walk my eye to a whole heap of things.
A whole heap of people are going to know now say it's not the original song. But the way all she sing it, it sound better than the original one.
Yeah, of course, by far.
Yeah, man, it sound better.
Make you want to listen to it more.
Yeah.
Yeah, and last time I realized she passed away, you know, age 73 then.
Tuesday she passed away.
Me they see her in a little talk like she had drink a champagne when she was 71.
Yes. But you didn't know, say, the first million selling album was done by Ari Belafonte, who the mother and father come from St. Anne.
Oh, the man who sing Daylight Come and Want to Go Home.
Yeah,
they.
I didn't know, say it's Miss Lou teach him a whole heap of the song them. Mm. Yeah, man.
And him go to America.
And him used to go to Woolman's.
Yeah?
Yeah, him used to go to Woolman's, Ari Belafonte. So I hold it for things.
Oh boy. I mean, I watch a little video with you two in the motor. This poem, you know, when some
a little video.
A little video.
By HBO.
Yeah, man. You go and go.
Yeah. Def Jam poetry.
You know, I read the thing. I mean, I remember every words in your mind, you know.
Oh, another one. The one in our Def Jam, did I read it?
At this point, man. Couple years about.
Yeah. Yeah, man, give thanks. Where are you call from?
Yeah, where's my call from? In the Southside, Raytown, there, you know.
Raytown, me come from, you know?
I know that. Then me and Roddy Isaac and all these talk about you, man.
Roddy, I'm a Bridget. Yeah, I like, can you not call me and tell me something, you know?
You know, say, the Bridget and me here talk about the hospital. You know, say, I'm a co-worker, father. The one where you see them trim off in bed.
Ryan.
Yeah. She texts me all the voice messages, them all them attack, and them want, like, them want to sue the people, them or whatsoever, some lawsuit of a put out or.
The family gets a lawyer, you know.
Years Rasta been through the whole thing.
I tell you, man.
Still come back and.
Terrible crime, lad.
Yeah. I mean, me's not a Rasta man, you know, but. I like the philosophy and the thing with.
Yeah. Well, from your day with me so long in the night, you must know, so you like Rasta.
Yeah, man, my brother, all right, you know, say, so go up on my hunger already, and my brother serve you, please. And him, I think he tell me, say, tell you, say, my brother will follow you in the motor. Yeah, man, the one up on Marketplace.
What's his name?
Them call him Priest.
Up on Marketplace?
Yeah, man. I'm kind of I run it off the IRR more times still. Yeah, I'm the one.
Okay.
The
IRR, yeah, man, give thanks, man.
Yeah, man, give thanks to your motor, man. I'm big up your wife, Jackie, you know?
All right. I think you're going to hear her tomorrow, too. Seal.
Yeah, motor.
Blessed man.
Wow, on the bridge.
Stepping razor, cutting edge, coronavirus, all of them things they are going.
Why, you know, I'm going good, you know.
Why? The stepping race cutting the coronavirus.
The corona thing, man. The corona thing that create a problem in the country, man. I tell you, man. Trust
me. Yeah, man, a serious thing.
The wicked motor, you know what I mean? I want a supermarket, you see? I do our business. I'm stand up at customer care, you know, and I look fast. I'm tell you something, Virgin. One of the cashier sneezes in the motor, everybody there don't
I can't imagine all that they see.
Motor, let me tell you something, man. All the Charlie, them are sorry, Charlie, them are all them motor. So my people, them are
saying,
I'm not in the motor. I mean, I said, what is this, man? That's serious, man.
And I want to tell you something. A bus had come down from Lawrence Tavern. And apparently a man dropped down dead in the bus. And I tell you, say, all through the window, man, I jumped through. Man, people had fly out of the bus. And the corona kill him, you know. And some problem in my body dead, you know. Police man come to me, but.
It's serious, man. You're about your virgin in the motor. You're virgin me, you want. Leave it. Imagine if you succeed, thing, it's a great problem too, you know. Hey, guys, you have all your bridge.
I don't want him come near you.
You have to see from your friend them. You know them, you know?
Yeah. Terrible,
it's
man.
It's a great problem. You know what I say? Me and a bridge in a driver going to town over there, you know. I want to reach out and walk through there. My bridge in, stop. And the three girls pass motor. Tell them to go cross the road. You hear me?
The three girls, they look good, you know, they look tight up thing, you know, you know.
You're the man now.
you're the best, you know. Girl, they look good still, you know, but they're full of corona.
How do you know to them have corona?
Why? I don't think it's setting them out. You know?
Well, I want to say a man going to shoot, you know, and you say a corona kill you. And that's what they know.
Well, all I come here, boy, right now, I tell you, Virgin, I first in my life, my beard, so you know, Mota.
Beard?
Yeah, man, make me beard anymore, me John, man.
But you know, I can't, I can't.
No, Mota, Mota,
I'm going to the phone, I'm going to the phone, I can't, I can't. I got the phone, we're gonna have a calf.
Yo, Mr. Biden, I sit here done, Motor. Biden, I sit here done, no half thing, me wash hand, me go down and no hand left.
Well, brother, you say my hands look like chicken foot.
white.
Look like chicken foot. No, shrivel up, we are talking about white, shrivel up.
Why, I tell you, my God. Why, yeah. Still, yeah, Motor, wait. Jamaica, we still are going good still, you know.
Eh?
We don't do like all the country, you know, like all of America.
No, me not compare nothing to nothing, you know, Rasta. Me not compare it, you know, a war.
Yeah.
Terrible, don't ya?
So everything all right, sir?
No, sir, you don't tell me say not all right. You don't tell me say not all right. No, you can't tell me everything all right. It's not all right.
You tell me everything all right, man, you know?
No, man, everything all right, man. No, we have to, man. Hey, watch out. I know some forest me there have to do the program, you know.
You know how we hear there, man?
You know you're the pinot out of them.
Yeah, man. Do you know you're talking to me outside me there? I talk to you right now, you know.
You have pinot out of it, too?
I want to talk about, man. I went up in a museum of Clarendon or something there, you know, man. You know, kill it, please.
So, you're fighting against the pinot out of them?
No, boss, man. The pinot out of it, man.
So where say a Clarendon you call from?
Right up in a Clarendon you somewhere.
Oh no, a corona them there, a corona.
No man, up here some man, corona now come cross up here some man.
Where are some man, them people dead up there already? What are you talking about?
People dead up there from corona. Yeah man, anyway. So just hold it and continue with the program. I like it, man. And
yeah man, give thanks, man.
Yeah, man, I respect you.
Yes.
Good morning. Night morning, actually. I'm here to talk about, like, the corona topic that you're on.
Talk again.
I'm here to talk about the corona topic that you're on.
Me never did party, you know.
All right,
since you want, go on it.
All right, like... Serious thing, on a level, like, I don't really think it's corona itself. They just give it a name to, like, trick out the population in terms of our way for the new advance of technology.
And so, what do you think it is?
I think it is radiation. Like, the radiation is affecting the weaker people in this that we're living in now. So, like... Okay. The new population it affect like the 5G where them put up now, like the radiation.
Which part of them 5G like, now in Jamaica?
They tell you that you know in Jamaica.
No, 5G. All right. All you know said that Jamaica.
In that, them a bring come here. Yes, that's why they.
No. Wait, let me ask you a question. You think the 5G in Jamaica?
Yes, like in Kingston,
you know.
Like where
they... Where in Kingston is there?
In Kingston.
Where?
I don't know where exactly because they're not going to leak out their most important
information. No, 5G is not a thing where you leak out. 5G is a thing where people put up in their country. People not have to hide to put up 5G.
Them put it up in their country, yes. We give up better service and signal.
Yeah, but no, but that not in Jamaica.
After effects. That's the after effects.
No, but that's not in Jamaica. It's not in Jamaica.
Huh?
Where you get it from? Where you get it from? Say 5G in a job. You read WhatsApp and the 5G. No, when 5G. Huh? Let me explain something to you. You see when you see the 5G, it have radiation, you know, where people must be afraid of. Just like yes, with a cell phone, and all. We are not. You see your cell phone where you have in a yard and talk to me.
Yes, I know it has a lot of radiation in it.
All right. We listen to me, you know. You see the 5G, it quite have more radiation. But now you see this thing we are going on named coronavirus. It is something where they are for a long time. Before 5G come in, they have coronavirus. This is a new strain of coronavirus, you know. Now, the place like Jamaica, people from England bring it come here, so. It's not 5G cause it. It's not 5G cause that. It's because you read too much of the things they out there, so that's why you said that it's not 5G cause it.
There's that no 5G is one Jamaica. Of the fact, but the next fact is that I was going to say, the first thing the government did wrong when he hear about the coronavirus going around, he sent back for people who probably all run away and never want to come back here. Him send back for them and bring them out here. Which
who's wait, no, hold on there.
Resources not even to take care of us.
Wait, no, hold on there. Who them send back for? Who them send back for?
Then come on the news and say then send back to one plane load of people.
All right, let me ask you a question. Wait, hold on there. If your mother and are you did there in England and you say you can't come back to Jamaica, you know I come back to Jamaica and can't come. You think say
but well, all right, Matthew. Intentionally, when they leave, they have no intention of coming back because
no, you can't say that. Sister, so they say
a better life. So,
no,
as long as possible until they send them back out here.
Look, here, you have people that work on ship, them work on the ship, you know, and come home when them not work, and then you say them can't come home. What you ask about them people there?
That's different.
Then most of them come back to there yesterday.
What you mean that different? They never want to come back because they leave and not even visit one time.
You know anybody where they on the plane right now where left and never want to come back?
Of course, people, especially the younger mind.
You know of anybody with the on the ship or the plane will never want to come back to Jamaica?
I know somebody that don't want to come back here from the first time he leave.
And them they on the plane now?
They're not on the plane, they're in another country.
In which country?
United States.
No, what I'm saying to you, listen to me now. There's a lot of people that left Jamaica and don't want to come back. Just like what there's a lot of people who are in America and want to come back. So I said to you now, if somebody in America, because them in America, it's because them don't want to come back that them in America. You really believe that?
But they can't. Actually, one second, my brother is insist to talk to you.
Your brother?
Yes.
All right, I can ask you a question. How old is?
I am 19.
You're 19? Okay. Yes. Me think was a little 7-year-old that talked to me. You sound like a 7-year-old or 8-year-old. Your voice.
Oh, yeah. Good night.
Good night, sir.
Well, what I've been hearing that this corona is a new strain. But we want to find out how much different strains of corona are there before this.
Them have SARS. Yes, you have corona. Look here. Corona about long time. If you look at the Lysol can, you see them have
coronavirus on it. And the Lysol can dead long before you hear about this corona. Yeah. See, so you have different strain of coronavirus. And they said this one is a different strain. Flu is a coronavirus. So it's not. This is not the first time coronavirus about.
You have coronavirus. It's a strain from it, but
it's a new kind. It's a new kind.
It's a new kind.
Yeah, it's a new kind of coronavirus. It's a coronavirus for the whole while, but it's a new kind.
It's just that some of these things, because I'm kind of do some research deeply, and when we get to find out, these people are breeding some all sorts of things.
Yeah, but whether them breed it or not, it dead there. So when I say them never breed it, may I say it dead there.
You know, that's still, and we realize what the government do in terms of, say, reduce the contact, rate of contact where it can transmit, because I want the best means missing so far. And but there's something unseen, and
the coronavirus is unseen.
Yeah, because.
And the guys, them who go and fix it. We don't know who go and fix it, but some guy go and fix it. It get from some guy, and some guy go and fix it.
But me think them not tackle it from the right perspective, because...
What is the right perspective?
All right. What do you get to realize that most of the things them where them even actually treat them for, it's not really and that... the symptoms. It's like they might treat them for a different type of symptom.
Well, we see that the other day when the woman dead.
Exactly. So
whenever you man youth attack a while ago say, right now if you sneeze, them say a coronavirus. If you go out and have new moon, them say a coronavirus. Yeah. So them don't even know is what?
At that I think is it that them don't know? I who know.
Nah, tell you.
So, it's like, it's fear reach a certain number. Them want to see a certain number where them say them can get the change their world to realize what kind of dramatic effect can happen. Because, I say corona is not a thing we can change spontaneously, you know, because there are so much threats out there where in our ear. Not just in the ear, but asteroids, all these things passing. So, when I said the corona not likely to mutate and become a more deadlier strain of virus.
Yeah.
But somehow, me no get that deep feeling that is the fact.
So, what kind of feeling you get?
There's some misleading.
All right, you know, brethren, let me tell you something. You see, the people them who cause this coronavirus, you have to let wild pan drop the people them in all over the world.
Yeah.
Them same people there go and find something to make it stop. So here we are going on, before them find that. You see what I'm telling you must know? Mother advise you if you do it. This when them tell you, say, put mask over your face. Put the mask over your face. You see them tell you, say, boy, right now, 6 foot, just do it. You see them say,
man,
just do it.
Why me say is that there can't be any faults by doing that, because for one thing, me personally, asthmatic, and me reducing certain contaminants in my ear can reduce a lot of effect where ago, keep my immune system away from other things. Where you see, because by certain things getting in your immune system, you can weaken it, you know? And then when it weakens to a certain state, a different type of strength can take over, which that can be in at this time or at this age. We don't know what going
on. But I can tell you something.
When a certain weakness of system.
Really, you see, like how you are talking about system and weak immune system. You see, all of the things that we are trying to figure out that now will help you right now. See, because that also helps you make you get nervous, make you fearful. All of the things that you are thinking about right now, but maybe it's that and maybe it's that and maybe it's not that, it make you get more. It's like you're nearer to getting the virus because your temperature will rise. And then they go test you and say your temperature high. You get nervous. You get tense. You start sweat. They go tell you, say, boy, that your blood pressure will rise. And I know because the coronavirus make it rise, you know, it's because the thing that we are hear about the coronavirus.
And yes, them sit up chest is a hell of a thing.
Yeah. So just look on it like this. Somebody out there started. And there's an opposition force where I tell you, say, them started. I don't like how them started. So I go show the people them how to prevent it. You understand? Yeah. So it's two forces. One I say, him started to do a terrible thing. And the next one I say, oh, him started before me. No, sir. I go tell the people them how to prevent it. So just find out how to prevent it. All right? We have to move.
All right.
Yeah, tell the 19-year-old you would say, it must stop the whole people go on the internet and find conspiracy theory. About 5G, this and 5G, that, you know.
No, you know, say I'm a youth, I'm a sister, still.
No, I'm saying 19, she said 19. Then no, a youth, 19, like, to me a youth, you know how much old means?
Yeah.
Could I be your father?
Eh?
Could I be your father?
Well, I know that, guys.
Yeah. That means a youth to me, 19-year-old a youth. My grandson older than him. So I'm going to say, this whole heap going on the internet for go find something other than the truth, where people are conjured for get you more fearful. The more theories about it you get, the more fearful you get. Right now, we need to get rid of some of the fear. Because the fear now start high blood pressure, tenseness, fever, and all them things there. I mean, after the corona, we don't know.
Can I mention one thing?
Yeah, man.
Before this start, like a week or about a 2 weeks before, I kind of get this, watch this video about Napoleon Hill, where it explains a lot of things about this fear complex and the gifting mentality and them way there. I don't know if you ever heard of it. And
you heard of what?
In some Napoleon Hill interview.
No, me hear about Napoleon. But what about Napoleon?
No, man, it was an interview, like I write a book about him, interview the devil, you see me?
Napoleon interviewed the devil.
Like, a lot of things.
Yeah. How happened?
Well, if I tell you, say, well, fear, I want to mean driving force. Cause we if deteriorate and cause we if not be.
Yeah, wait there. What do you think religion is? Religion is the greatest fear is in religion.
Mm-hmm.
The greatest fear is in religion. Fear God and live. May I tell you? Anyway, we have to move, brethren.
Yeah, man, and that's one thing. I think
it's no, more than one thing, I 1,000 things you got, you know.
His name Tafari, my name are the same, isn't it?
Yeah, from the car out in the east and out in the St. Thomas, you know?
St. Thomas?
Yeah, man, St. Thomas, man. Yeah, man, the parish of Paul Bogle, man, you know. The works of Paul Bogle still live on the same way, you know.
Whenever you hear me talk about Paul Bogle.
Yeah, man, earlier, of course, man. I talk about Paul Bogle, man. I talk about Center, man. Same way, man. I give thanks to that Father Motor, man. All you give
thanks
to
you mean, man?
The highlight Center, man, you know?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
The most neglected parish. Yeah. You hear them talk about them going to build highway through it now?
Yeah, Father Motor, right now. Yeah, we are listening to them, you know? We are listening to them, man. It's gonna be we're not gonna hear them say it, so obviously it become practical, you know, cause a long time sentiment people really are wait for, you know, this highway. We need good roads, we can have community, then we can move from point A to point B. So We are wait for that kind of language, so we are wait still, you know?
Yeah, man.
We are there and wait still.
Well, you don't want to wait in vain.
And that's the thing for them, with 20 years, they are wait still, you know? And I hear
you serious?
It
is easier
survive half of it, take care of them family and take care of them household and so. I know me see a majority of those factories gone down and trust me and the man in the dig off at St. Thomas, all our resources, you know, within St. Thomas and move out, you know, and are going to other parishes, you know, and me know, see, it will benefit St. Thomas for the whole, you know. St. Thomas still a cry, and if it's a time for the people of St. Thomas to get up and rise up, you know what I mean, and defend what is ours, you know, and start sit down and because we're not blind, you know, we are so going, you know, we're not talking about it. We're not talking about it, and it's an injustice towards St. Thomas still, but you know, I am here as a son of St. Thomas, you know. I'm a bridging melanin, same way, son of St. Thomas, you know. I want to talk to St. Thomas and talk about St. Thomas, because them need to treat St. Thomas more better than how them are treat St. Thomas right now. You know, we see other parishes that go forward in a development, yeah, and we don't have St. Thomas that go forward in a nothing. We don't count. We don't count. What we do? So, I want St. Thomas people do. So, it because what?
You know what I want to do? I can tell you what I want to do. Yo. I can tell you what I want to do. Uno shouldn't rise up against governor here. That is what I want to do.
Yeah.
Uno shouldn't bring this deacon named Paul Bogle to create problem.
The longest while?
What do you mean the longest while?
They have started somewhere. It definitely, they have started somewhere. So Paul Bogle was brave enough to get up and start it. You know what I mean? And other places right now too, outside of the Kingston, outside of the St. James and the St. Anne, where them all is a highlight. And which not, then Father Mountain, I didn't believe it. What the matter about tourism place, you know, Kingston, I talk about again, you know. Yeah, because for the longest while, you know, then the tourists, they didn't want tourists to come at Kingston, outside of Kingston, they want the tourists to go.
Well, what chance them not come to Kingston be a tourist attraction?
Huh?
Well, them gentrify downtown, you say, we are going.
Yeah, but I see, because, trust me, right now, when we look downtown, too, because I realize, you know, I look at sell them and they look at this, you know, I realize so they want to move them around. And
I better know that. And it's when them build the highway through St. Thomas.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody don't know which part of St. Thomas they are getting, and the highway them know.
Yeah, and I'm going to tell them, Father Mota, about 2 years ago, I got to the center, and I remember them back room for the people, them all of them region, they used to have their little stall and so the tourists, them used to come and them thing there. No, I think I'm around there, so I see all of them.
I wear. Yes, man.
You know what I mean? So I realize, that the different administration, them on a whole, they don't really care about the small man, them, the small man in the county, you know.
So I just know you know that.
Sometimes somehow I didn't say if I know me know, I just know me know. Cause trust me, and every 2 years I know at once, you know. But the greatest thing to get the chance to know you now. Yeah, man, but otherwise from the center man thing up for the more trouble. I mean the African countries them, cause right now, you see the work where Paul Kagame I do. Right now in a Rwanda, trust me, yo, the work is so marvelous, man. Trust me. We may see the CMA compare Rwanda right now to Singapore.
Yeah.
The development, trust me, yo, the way, yo, I think that, because right now, I'm in a Father Mutter, right now, as government, you sit there and want to think about new ideas, you know. When you look at a country like Rwanda, when you see Paul Kagame, you could look at a Singapore and say, all right, this is how we are going to turn. Rwanda. I said, why our Jamaican government and our government within the Caribbean can look to a Rwanda? I look at country like Rwanda, that's all right? All right. Them blueprint that we can take it. When I say, we take the whole blueprint in the book, at least some aspect of it.
And the Chinese are going to come and America are going to get jealous and come again. I have we like a yo-yo.
Yeah.
Between the Chinese and the Americans, it's like ping pong.
Oh gosh, man. And my look at the father Muta, we see we call him Bobby White, we see in Uganda. Trust me, Mr. Virgin, you know, in the love in the spirit, you know, I really hope that he really hope he become the president of Uganda, you know, because when I did the research, you know, Father Muta, any youth under 37 don't know no more government than the man in a poor right now.
Yeah.
And the man in a poor so long. And the
man, well, we have to move. We have to move. It's not like you have enough things to say. We have to go move.
No problem, Father Muta, man. Give thanks for the opportunity.
Give to thanks. Away, man. Of yes, course, man. Yeah, man. Yes. Cutting edge. You know the man in here. May I tell you? We're there with you. Yes, EL.
Muta.
Yes.
Morning. I'm going to start calling Dr. Muta now. May I call you about some little thing now? How the birthday go?
Which birthday? Your birthday?
Oh, you're one day that day when you need a techno call.
Yes. You think it's our birthday if you did have?
You did have. You know that me yesterday, the other night, it's not 2 o'clock, me yesterday, boy, your birthday come the other day. And then, me know you a techno call.
I never take no call because we are trying to figure it out.
Start calling Dr. Motor still. Tomorrow we are making
sure
come
tell
from
you,
work early.
Yeah, listen, when if I ever tell you how this call has come, you would have said, you're going to call me doctor. You're going to call me which doctor?
Tell me,
Motor. No, I'm not telling you, man. Because you're going to go do it, too. And then you call me.
Big up yourself. I call you from Marvelin. I'm come in early tomorrow to listen to the program.
Of course. How old is?
Corona.
Who am Corona?
Me day, man.
Let me tell you, man. As so much people, watch out. You have too much man with me now, you know. Enough man. Me see how play with you all around the place, you know. Oh, Corona. So, me think I made it, love.
Oh, so tomorrow. I'm going to call you back in the day, in the evening.
All right, Corona.
All right, Muta, my dad.
Are you the panel lips of everybody now?
Are you a try to lead the people in the right way, you know, call them? Nah, listen. I'm here, you yeah. Start the program, I tell them to listen, man, and keep a distant time now. But they come like to them, I tell you about them a research, and them a this, and them a that. That's foolish.
What them a research?
Foolish, you say, my dad. And if my research, I'm dead before them find the answer. You are trying to tell the people, them, say, listen, wear the mask if the people themselves wear the mask.
People, who don't listen to the one who are doing the disease. You're the disease, they're for the phone.
You said the man come out the window, you could have wind it up. Because the man, if you know, say, if you stay a distance from you, them time at too.
Yeah, but I tell you, people, who don't hear what Corona say, this is disease, they're for the radio. Listen to what you are saying, you listen to me. That.
Anyway, Muta, my man, you just want to write in because when this part, still want to hear it on the radio.
Oh, you mean, of course, it's all sweeter. It's all sweeter. Harry.
Bless up yourself.
Yeah.
Shoes them early. I'm coming to see you, baby. When we reach, we want you hold me, girl. You are my bright sunshine. I'm so glad to call you mine. Let me love you for life. There is this feeling.
I say, give thanks to the moment, give thanks to the time and the energy. As I tell you before, we'll be back here. At 2 o'clock with the stepping razor, the art of war. We want to heal up the operator. We don't know who the operator. Shane, who are the operator down there? Shane, who are the operator?
You know, say the man, brethren. We don't know him name, you know.
Asleep, Shane, asleep.
Oh, Matrix, I tell me say him name, Castell.
Oh, the tall brother, do I look like Chad?
A black version of Chad.
Yeah. Matrix same name, Castell.
I call him a black version of Chad. He look like Chad, man.
Well,
I don't know why I yell him up. Matrix in that studio, why I yell up Matrix, you know?
Yeah, man, him there, man.
Matrix.
Blessing, man. Wagwan.
Well, I don't know if you ever see me in that studio there again, you know, Matrix.
Eh?
You ever see me in that studio there again, you know?
What you say? You're not half hour there again.
So all the things you ever give me it now.
Right now.
Watch out. We say, remember studio right here, so with me. The only thing we don't have is the account department upstairs.
They ain't set, man, everything good.
Yeah, man, everything nice, man. Give thanks.
Yeah, if we go put
so,
one
give thanks to Shane, you know, because I tell you, Shane professional, tell him he can't professional no more. Me like how you make the thing no sound like how it sound when it not sound. You know? All the things sound. If you don't know how it sound, you think that's how it's supposed to sound.
Yeah, man. Well, you always a big up Nigel and thing over there, so you know, but we have to big up wisdom from our side as well, too.
Yep, you mean crack, wisdom.
Yeah, man, wisdom. Dr. Crack.
Dr. Crack, oh gosh, man, Dr. Crack, the school, the Sunday school teacher, man.
Yeah, man, as well as Shamara, because Shamara not
so
too long.
People?
Yeah, man, put up.
We're gone, I'll take a little more.